gedaan. Dan zou ik bijvoorbeeld het woord eneane gebruiken. Omdat dat op dat moment een andere uitdrukking is van hetzelfde fenomeen. Een Lemuriaanse taal is dus nooit gebaseerd op vaste waarden. Er zijn geen vaste woorden in het Lemuriaans en in andere, zelfs nog oudere, geometrische talen. Alles is gebaseerd op de akene en op het communiceren van de akene op dat moment. Hetzelfde geldt met bewegingsleer, die we zo dadelijk een klein beetje met jullie zullen gaan doen, om jullie het genot te geven van het voelen van geometrie en de vrijheid die dat met zich meebrengt. Eya Ichipa, bijvoorbeeld, is een bewegingsleer, geometrisch gebaseerd, dus niet vooraf bepaald. We beginnen allemaal wel op eenzelfde moment, met eenzelfde akene-intentie, maar vanaf dat moment worden we allemaal een aparte en dus gezamenlijke uitdrukking van dezelfde beweging. Dat is een hele mooie ervaring om dat mee te maken. Vooral wanneer je niet in je angst gaat. Want als je in je angst gaat, dan ga je denken dat jij die beweging helemaal niet kan genereren. Dat is helemaal niet zo. Iedereen kan alles. Iedereen kan elke beweging genereren. Iedereen kan elk gesprek en elke verandering in gang zetten. Omdat we weten dat wij op onszelf een bron zijn. Dat het mogelijk is om verandering te genereren. En sommigen onder jullie die hier zijn, weten dat maar al te goed. Dat dat kan. En hoe dat kan. En hoe dat moet. Het is de bedoeling om uit de denkgeest te gaan, zodat je zelf die bron kan ervaren. Voordat we naar de Eya Ichipa gaan, en naar de rest van de dag, zou ik jullie een moment willen geven, een mogelijkheid willen geven, om afscheid te nemen van iemand, iets, jullie al lang heel erg graag zien, waar jullie al lang een heel intieme relatie mee hebben. Een hele mooie relatie geweest bij momenten, want het heeft jou gegeven wat je wilde, maar een relatie die je niet langer meer nodig hebt. De relatie die ik bedoel, is de relatie met de denkgeest. We gaan afscheid nemen van de denkgeest. De eerste stap daarvan tenminste. Ik ga zo dadelijk jullie vragen om jullie kaarsje te nemen. James gaat zorgen voor gitaarmuziek. Maar zodra we die kaars hebben genomen, zorg ook dat je een lichtje erbij hebt, zodat je de kaars straks kan aansteken. Wat ik jullie nog wil vertellen, is dat er tegenwoordig heel veel muziek is op deze wereld. Muziek die eigenlijk zeer sterk uitdrukt waar wij nu ook op dit moment mee bezig zijn. Ik weet dat het een beetje vreemd lijkt om op dat vlak namen te noemen. Zeker de namen die ik dan zou noemen. Maar denk eens aan de grote iconen van deze wereld. Michael Jackson, Heal the World. The Man in the Mirror. I am starting with the man in the mirror. I am asking him to change his ways. Zoveel nummers. Celine Dion, die je gisteren hebt gehoord in The Power of the Dream. Heel duidelijk nummer. Maar vooral een van de duidelijkste is zeker in de laatste jaren Madonna. Gigantisch icoon, ze heeft haar naam ook niet gestolen. Maar als je luistert naar die muziek, en zeker een van haar laatste cd's, American Life, dan vind je de ene song na de andere die allemaal gebaseerd is over het afscheid nemen van de denkgeest. Eén nummer dat we zo dadelijk zullen gaan gebruiken is The Power of Goodbye. En The Power of Goodbye gaat eigenlijk letterlijk over het afscheid nemen van de denkgeest wanneer je de denkgeest hebt bekeken als een liefdesrelatie. Alles zit erin. I want to go higher. Luister straks maar naar de nummers die we zullen gebruiken en je zal zien in hoeveel plekken je tegenwoordig waarheid kan vinden en in hoeveel manieren je daarin ook kan gesteund worden. Maar ook een van haar duidelijkste nummers tegenwoordig is Hey You. Een ander nummer dat ik me kan inbeelden is The Love Profusion. Het gaat erover dat er eigenlijk veel te veel vragen zijn en dat er veel te veel verwachtingen geweest zijn, maar dat het eigenlijk alleen maar gaat om een doordrongen zijn van de liefde. Frozen is natuurlijk heel belangrijk en ik kan blijven doorgaan. Maar het nummer dat ik heb gekozen voor vandaag is The Power of Goodbye. gaan afscheid nemen van onze denkgeest. En James.
So it is. There is a greater truth inside, a greater power. There is a God inside. You are divine. You are the universe. Thought that you have, everything that you think is real. You have a responsibility to yourself to choose only those thoughts that will benefit love that is you, the joy that radiates from you at any given moment, even if you yourself can't see the freedom. Feel the freedom. Feel the space. Space that comes from consciousness, bigger than the earth itself, bigger than the universe. We are all connected. Imagine your DNA, two strands interlinking, connecting, defining you, defining the way you look, even the way you feel, until you open up. See those two strands of DNA light up, lighting up everywhere inside of you. Everywhere. From those strings, thousands and thousands and thousands of lights start to come loose. Creating more strings. Going beyond the boundaries of the flesh, the boundaries of the body. Connecting with those people sitting next to you, in front of you, behind you. Connecting with those people in your past and those in your future. Connecting. You have a right, you know, a right to live with 144 activated strands of DNA. It's your right, your birth right. So, and as you connect to all those people around you throughout space and time, I invite you to follow the path all the way back. Let the years pass. We're going far now. Far, far away, hundreds of years back into time, thousands of years, going beyond the birth of Christ, beyond the beginning of the Egyptian society, beyond the beginning of Asia. You're seeing continents now, continents that you never knew were there on the planet. Lemuria. You can see Lemuria. Its golden beaches, its golden sunlight, its golden shimmering towers, and what seem to be people. People. Are they really people? You touch them, try to touch them. You see what happens. You see how they touch your heart and start connecting with you, opening up, exchanging frequencies. So magnificent, so beautiful. Then they're telling you, go, go further, further back through time. And you do. You see the earth getting younger. You see the earth as it has just been born. You see the angels. The angels that chose to connect to this planet, the original beings of light. Your DNA brings you there. You are connected to those original beings of light and love and grace, power. Power of creation. Can you see their vision, human? Can you see their vision, Master, that they once held for this planet? The 12th in row on its way to complete and utter liberation. Can you see the vision? And maybe, just maybe,
you can see. Maybe you were one of these original 500 beings of light. Come in to create this earth and all that will stem forth from it. You, as you sit here now, are part of that creation. You were thought of, you were conceptualized as an expression of God, an expression of the divine, so that you could make a difference. And within you is the power of all those beings of light, all those societies that you have seen and have traveled through, Lemuria, all the other continents, it's within you. It's within your DNA. Now we're gonna go further to a point when the Earth wasn't yet born. Let's follow those beings back to where they came from. Now we're traveling through the galaxy, traveling through the cosmos, entering star after star after star, as we are following the pathway of the gods, as we are following the portals. We arrive at the great central sun. Around you, nothing but light. Whiteness. A shimmering, that's all you are, a shimmering of energy. As you are invited to reconnect again to that place of birth, that place of creation. Connect now. Have no fear. Go into that space that is the great central sun. This is where your DNA brings you now to have another meeting with yourself, God. And this time, you see yourself much like you are today, sitting. What are you sitting on? Do you dare to know that that is your throne, King? Do you dare to see the mantle that you are wearing, Queen? You are magnificent. You are as bright as all the stars in the sky put together in one moment of great union. That is you. And as you are meeting with yourself once again, sharing all those stories that you have lived, all those lives that you have lived, all those names that you have carried, and laughing because of them, see yourself holding a candle. What is it for? You ask yourself. This, my dear, you say, this is the universe. Right there in that candle. I don't understand. Well, this candle has been created out of energy. And as you are looking
to the candle, you see the patterning, how that energy got turned into matter. It's just matter. Seems like you have no control over it. But that is because you think you are the matter, you see. No, I don't. Well then, look through your pockets. Okay. You find a lighter. You think you are the candle, you tell yourself. But you aren't. A candle has been created to support you. The candle is there in matter, so that you can reclaim that matter and shape its divinity. But if I'm not the candle, then what am I? You are. You are the light. Would you light the candle? And you do. And as you do, you begin to understand, you begin to see this beautiful, beautiful dance of the flame. Do you see it dance? Do you see it spin all around? Do you see it play? That's your blade. That's your light. That's who you are. You came to this earth to be that light so that you could transform all matter around you like the candle flame turns the candle into energy, sets the matter free yet again. That is what you do as a god. That is what you do as a creator. First you create, and then you undefine your creation once again and you set it free. That is why you are the light. That is why. As you look into that candlelight, you begin to understand something about yourself. You begin to understand that you don't need to plan your future. You don't need to plan the way your light will dance. All the cosmos is a giant dance. You are the dancer. You are the light of the candle as it is dancing around, playing around. The light never thinks about the way it is moving, never thinks about its next move. It just knows that its next move will happen, and it will be perfect. You are perfect. How could anyone ever tell you that you weren't? How could you ever have believed such nonsense? You are perfect. The way you are dancing is unique. The way your light shines is unique. I understand. My God, I understand, you say. But what? But I have to go back. If I have to go back, how will I remember that I am perfect? How will I remember that I can do my dance without anyone controlling me? How will I understand? How will I see? Oh. Well, that's very simple. As soon as you will be back, As soon as you will open your eyes, you will see the gifts all around you. We'll begin with the candle that you will still hold in your hand, or that you will see somewhere near you. Find the gifts in all matter around you. That's why it was created in the first place, so that you could be reminded of who you really are, so that you could do your dance, so that you could be the light, so that you could be the flame. Sometimes it feels as though all things around me, all people around me are just trying to take my light away. Like you're trying to blow out my candle. You see? Yes, I see. Are you gonna let them? What's the big deal? If your candle is blown out, you just light it up again. You are the light. How can someone shut you off from it? How can someone take your love away? How can someone or something take your joy away? How can something put you in jail? You are free. Free spirit. Doing the cosmic dance of the flame, always knowing, always trusting, the next move will be perfect. I want to dance. I want to be free. I want to be in love. I want to be in joy. I want to unite myself with everything around me. Please, won't you help me? Won't you come back with me? Oh, little one. Don't you see? Don't you see where you are? You didn't go anywhere. You just went deep, deep within. As you open your eyes later on, all you will do is leave that space, that undefined space of free energy that is your akene, that is the center of your heart. But every time it gets too hard, you can just close your eyes and talk to me. I'll be there. You don't have to go far. But I can't get to my heart sometimes. Sometimes I feel stuck. What makes you feel stuck? The bills I have to pay and everything around me. All those problems. All those thoughts, all those emotions. Yes. You were responsible for them. You have invited them. I don't want them anymore. Well then, do you have the guts to say goodbye? Do you have the guts to go, to let it go away? Completely. Let what go away? The mind. It's the mind that is trying to blow out your candle time and time and time again. I think I'm ready.
You think? Ready for what?
Ready to say goodbye. Yes. But there's just one more thing before I go. If I say goodbye, then
Won't I be alone? Won't I be more alone than ever if my thoughts are gone? No. No, you see, you have been in a little box with your mind. Once you go away from the mind, you will step into a landscape, more space. You'll never be alone. You'll be able to connect to everything around you. Do you hear the music far, far away?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's you playing that music. Just like you are holding that candle somewhere. That's your angel. Somewhere. Just go towards it. But first, as you travel back to your body, as you will come out of your heart and go back to your body, take some time. Take some time to say goodbye. Goodbye to the mind. Goodbye to that love affair that has been holding you back. Time to say goodbye. And so it is.
Let's go.